Okay, load it metal here. Car behind me. One second. Okay. Okay, I just brought some stuff from my garage. Could be copper even. Let's see about that. I found some wire. Didn't even know I had it sitting there. So what's this stuff here? Oh. Some strippable stuff here. That's a 12 gauge in here. I have to figure out what I'm gonna do with this. There's a grinder I bought. 7-inch grinder. Most aluminum wire. When I found my neighbor threw out which wire. No carton is usable. I don't mind selling this stuff because this stuff, they pay really good for this stuff. But the stove wires, they don't pay that much. I can make better money if I strip myself. Oh, look at that, heavy wires. Stuff I'm gonna strip myself. Twelve gauge is nice stuff. This stuff is good. Stuff I'm gonna keep. Okay, so this stuff I might sell the way it is. Get some more wire here. Yeah, let's see if I can solve some of these wheels. I have some pairs that have good tires on there, so I might try that. On my cutter. Not sure about these transformers. It's like wires. It's not like it's copper. It's old copper, it's wires wrapped around. So I may just scrap this the way it is. Just because it's not bare copper wires. These are copper. These might come apart. Okay, maybe I'll keep them here. Separate. Lots of plugs here and just scraps. Okay, I want to show you here. Stainless. See? They fused together, steel and stainless, and that's on a frying pan handle. So come on, so you don't have to saw it, you can just break it off right by the weld. See that? So now we could have a touch there, but just a little touch here. See if we can break it a little more. Did it break or no? Did it break? No. Go a little deeper. See, stainless steel's tough. See? Break it a little closer next time. So it's gonna be 100% clean, but okay, it's better anyways. Just a little tip here, which shows you the bonding metals together. Look at the rain, just everything's just, I don't know how many drill holes I drill. I almost forget more buckets. I have to drill more holes. Okay. quite stainless. So I'm gonna try to do some stainless steel. Still have this to take it out. I'll clean all this garbage on the ground later. Start getting on top of my yard. Clean the workbench area. Amazing how it doesn't want to come out. It's in there, grew pretty good. I'm doing it, I'll probably forget about this. This stuff is not coming out. Oh, it's in so good. This one's not coming at all. Let's see if I can. Okay, let's get some other tools here. Figure it out. Okay, I got this commercial washer. Not sure where to start, but I'll show you. It looks like a stainless steel bucket, stainless steel top, door, whatever else, lid. Lady said it did work 15 years ago. That's 15 years ago. Oh, it's got a cast drum too. Very bizarre. Battery's going. Okay, clean up around here a little bit. It's a little bit of my clean in the morning, a little bit. These are some of the plugs I have. These are all from dryers and stoves. I think I have another whole container like that too somewhere. They definitely, I sold some before. They said low recovery brass. They paid 30 cents before, so if they pay 30 cents again, I'll do it pound, but we'll see. Last time they didn't want it, but that's because brass is too low. When metals come high, people start buying stuff. I don't care, as long as there's some kind of recovery. Hardwired. These are commercial. Another piece here. I just don't know how I'm gonna get the top off here. It's got a lock. You can try the lock out. Oh, this is not hard. Wow, there's lots of stuff in there. Look at that, huh? Just the magnet on this thing. Okay. It's definitely stainless steel. Brass and nut. Okay. Clean stainless steel here. It's heavy, like 10 pounds. Pretty close to. Let's see if I can pry this door off. And they're pretty good. Avoiding taking all the screws out here. Don't want so many screws. This might be a soap thing, I guess. Soap dispenser, maybe? I don't know. Let's see, this is where it's being held by this rod. When in doubt, stomp on it. Okay, this is garbage here. Check this door here. It's stainless steel. Okay. This is stainless steel too. Okay, where do we start? Pump mortars, I think. I'm Manager's money, but I don't hear no money, so probably hear it if there's money there. Wow, it's pretty complicated looking. Heavy steel frame around it. See, everything is kind of like crisscrossed. You have to take that off to get this off. Two more screws here. Look at this. It's a weird little sensors or some kind of water thing. Here. Probably relays here, maybe. You can see it probably wouldn't work, this thing is too much corrosion and rust everywhere. It's sitting too long. Plus the styles are long gone. They're different styles now. Amazing how many wires are here, it's unbelievable. Oh, I saw a spider, it ran away. Maybe a wolf spider, who knows? Let me just get all the wires out, I'll get back to you. This thing probably get it off. These are all relays that gotta be stripped. problems. Everything's so rusty. I don't want to smash it off. Okay. These are going to be relays inside. There'll be contacts and so on in there. Couple mortars here, lots of relays. This is going to be full of brass. Be lots of brass in that. Okay, back to steel again. Excuse me. Hate that. I can get these out. Something, huh? The cast, yeah. Well, they have to have a super long socket here. I don't know. Should put an extension on it, maybe. Or maybe double extension. Looks cast up front there. I don't want my tools are all just frozen. Okay, it's always a way, right? It fits in here. Okay. Cast aluminum. Aluminum. There's my spider friend right there. Get out. There's that little hiding spot right there. See that? That's heavy. 5 pounds. There's no money. Take the front plate off here. Spencer part. Relays here. Come on, son, where are ya? Probably loose, just gonna hammer this part out. Looks like it goes into a slot. I don't know what hammer is now. I think we'll hammer out. There's a screw there, but how do I get to it? Oh, I see, just on a very low angle. Hmm. that one. You just can't even see it. It's just buried in there. Let me answer this phone here. Okay. What a pain to try to get this out. I just mashed it all. Could not get to it. Could not get to it. It was jamming up. It was slopping all over the place. Stupid thing. Tools. Brand new tools. It's just crap. It's at Summit Tools. Half the tools are just too cheap. They weren't cheap, these things, and they're just... Anyways. Let's just cast. Okay. Awesome. The tumblers go for the quarters. I think it's clean, but it looks dirty here. In here, behind there. This has to come apart somehow. Like that, I guess. You're probably saying, hey, you could be selling that. Well, sure, I could be selling that, but who's going to buy it? Because everything now, you know, because people break into machines all the time, so now they're all done by local credit card debit. No one uses coins anymore. Very rarely. All the laundromats and park buildings. Okay, so let's cast here. Okay, cast. So this is what we got here now. Let's get this hose off. Okay. Let's just see what's inside one of these things. It's a flat screwdriver. They look like mortars, but it might not be mortars, so I'm not sure. I would think they are. They're a different style than the ones we normally see. This might be the old style. It's kind of like half aluminum, half stainless steel here. I'm not sure how it's going to strip apart, to be honest. It's pretty heavy duty and really heavy. Heavy cast on there. Maybe there's a thin inside stainless steel and the rest is a cast drum. I'm not really sure. Okay, let me just get these unscrewed here and then I'll show you in a second. It's like a transformer sealed, so I'm not really sure, to be honest, what's going on. Let me just cut my eyes here. Really hard stuff. Not that easy to break apart. Yeah, I don't know. It's probably like a mortar or some sort of like a mortar. I mean, there's windings here, but anyways. A little bit too hard to break. I need to get glasses, so I'm not gonna bother for now, but definitely some sort of transformer type mortar. Get in there. Weird, I don't know. Just a little gap there between the drum. Okay, let me just start getting some of this stuff prepared here, because right now I need all type of different sockets. But okay, stand by. Two bolts on each side. All sort of having a problem with the bits there. They're like they're weird size, metric or something. Just tried my sockets, didn't work. Another one here, a couple, but see if nothing fits. It's got a weird size. It's not the right size. Just asking my socket set, nothing fits. I tried everything here. Okay, let me get a socket set. Okay, it's a 10 mil socket, so got it off. I'm working on, I can't believe how much material there is here. So, oh, I don't know, it's making this heavy, the mortar or what? Still super heavy. Looks like the wire pretty well off. Okay. Capacitors. That's a stupid socket. Said there's no. Look at this. This is what they do. They make crap with this. See, you can't put one of those drills on it. This was like from Acklins. That's why I threw them all in the scrap. They scrapped it all. Just no crap that people don't want. Let's get a wrench on the other side of that thing. I could probably just leave that on there, really. I don't have to take it off, but it's these things here. See, I don't have a socket that big. That's the problem. Actually, I might just grind it here. And I'll take the strapping off. At least that. Okay, let me get the grinder out. Okay, stand by. Doesn't reach. That's why I like these small grinders. That's why I bought a bigger grinder, because it doesn't you know, when you're cutting these big bolts in there and kind of stuck in positions. The blade is still good, it's just doesn't fit. Okay, let's try it again. Yeah, the pressure there, huh? Buckled. Better angle this way, I think. Be heavy drummer sound. Do that. Oh, very heavy. Okay. Let's see what we can take off here now. It's the first time I ever stripped something like this, so kind of learning as I go, because there's so many things in there. See nothing there. There's definitely something holding there. It's 10 mil again. And if you had a whole whack of these things. Something's holding there, but I'm not able to grab it. My drill. Torx. That's why. Okay, let me just get that off. Stand by. I'm not separated. So, it's a big mortar in here. So, how's it come out? Knock the pin out. For me. Something needs to put together. I don't think the pin will come out. It's almost coming out. There's a big, not sure. Okay, can't fool around with this like that. Going on here while I'm going to come out. Oh, it's just so heavy, that mortar. I can't believe it. Okay, I stripped the basket here, but can't seem to get this gear off, so I have to sell dirty or something, because it's really heavy gear here. Try cutting it here and stuff, but just can't seem to penetrate it. One thought is I can maybe cut it along here, but then I'm wasting blades. It's not really that much aluminum, like stainless there. Blades seem to go pretty quick. I don't know, these cheap blades. They were pretty good DeWalt's before, but they went a little cheaper, but the quality went really cheap. Before it was actually cheap and the quality was really good. So I got two little mortars here. Another mortar. This is the copper mortar that came out of the main mortar. This is aluminum. I even stripped all these capacitors, took the casings off. That's all aluminum, stainless steel here too. These two in here, it's all clean. Here's some heavy metal. How heavy is this thing? I don't know, maybe 35, 40 pounds, 40 pounds I would think. So just, I don't know, fighting rain, and rain stops, goes. Yeah, so I'll probably end up, like I say, here's that this side part here, and then the heavy metal. So I don't know. It's a shame it can't get off. It's a heavy cast plate there also. It just can't get out. I don't know how much they'll pay. I may have to save this for the Asian yard. They might pay a little better. Because when you call stainless steel, they say, you know, they won't pay as much. Aluminum, they're okay. Stainless, dirty, they still pay very little. So I may save that. Because there's probably at least 10, 15 pounds of cast here. It's really thick. And then we have probably like maybe 10 pounds here. Say 10 and 10, say 20 pounds. And then we have the steel there, another 10 pounds of steel probably. Weighs about 30 pounds, so I took the mortar of that thing. It's aluminum. I'm trying to get load together, but it's impossible. This thing took forever. Too much cutting involved, and you know, hard to get stuff out, and had to cut stuff right. I was fiddling with this thing for quite a while. I took that big brown thing off. took it off. They were broken to pieces. So, anyways, it's done. I have a furnace over there and have the freezer. And I'm gonna bring. You can see it kind of cleared out pretty good there already. You know, look at this. I got a walkway here now. Right? Lots of sinks here, so I'll determine what sinks I could clean quick. I'll run a load tomorrow. I'm gonna work a little more anyways, but it's just the weather sucks. I don't worry about the aluminum right now because, you know, I got so much aluminum if I start taking stuff apart. But here's my pile again, already started, you see that? These are really heavy, probably like 2-3 pounds. And 25 pounds probably. My stainless here. So the of a barbecue and all those sinks. Stainless steel rod. I mean, it was pretty interesting to tear it apart, but time consuming. That's a heavy plate here. Okay, so see what else happens. I'm gonna throw the stuff in the garage. These little mortars. It's a big black widow spider. Inside this mortar, had a nest in there. Looked like a black widow, same kind of body, but hard to say. Could be the male version or something. So, but the nice copper mortar for sure. Okay, so here are these wrenches I found when I did a cleanup. Made in India, never seen that before. Okay, keep moving.